Well, good morning. Thank you for joining us this morning at Fight the Good Fight Ministries. We are so blessed today to have my wife, Pastor Shannon. She's going to be bringing the Word of God. I just want to open up real quick and just, you know, share a few things. You know, we're in perilous times right now. You know, we're looking to go back to stage one with all this coronavirus and stuff going on. And people are just, you know, here's the thing. Tomorrow is not promised to any of us. And we're going to open up in prayer right now. But I also want to, I want to put a dear friend of ours, family in prayer.
Yes.
Pastor Adrian Ewan, he went on to be with the Lord this past week. So we want to pray for the Ewan family up in Hawaii.
Yes.
Tough time for them. I know what it is to lose a father,
yes.
A mentor, a friend.
Yes.
As we bow in prayer, it's open up in the service. I also want to pray for the Ewan family.
Yes.
Amen. Okay, so let's just humbly bow our heads
before
the Lord. Father, we just come right now, Lord, in the mighty name of your Son, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Father. Lord, right now, we want to lift up the Ewan family, God. We want to just lift all his kids up right now to you, Father, Lord. And we ask, Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Father, that you let them find strength and comfort right now, God, in your arms, Lord. Lord, because I know what it's like to, like I said, to lose a mentor, to lose a friend, to lose a father, God, to somebody that you depend on, Lord, that you could confide in, Lord, that you're confidant, God. And Lord, just somebody that you think that will never leave.
Yes.
But Lord, we all know we have an expiration date, God. But Lord, what we're grateful for, God, is what Pastor Ewan did while he was here, God. He served you, Father.
Yes, Father.
And Lord, he brought the purpose of the cross to people, God. The purpose of your Son Jesus' crucifixion and resurrection,
yes,
God. What you had in store for us, God. He walked his walk, God. Was he a perfect man? No. But he was a man that loved you and chased after your heart, God.
Yes.
So, Father, we just lift his family up to you right now, Lord. And anybody involved with Pastor Ewan, Lord, let them know that, Lord, his life meant something.
Yes, my God.
But much more, Lord, he did your will.
Yes.
And it was his time, Father.
Yes, Father.
Just as you called my father home, God, you called Pastor Ewan.
Yes.
And, Lord, to go with that, Lord, you called a dear friend of ours home as well, Father God.
Yes.
Herman, Father. He departed from us as well, Father. But,
yes.
Lord, we just put the families in your hands, Father.
Yes, Lord. Thank you.
So, Lord, we thank you for the peace that you give us, God.
Yes.
And, Lord, help us, Lord, when we remember Pastor Ewan or Herman, Lord, that, Lord, we can carry on the ministry, God, and keep moving forward and keep making believers, Lord, and reaching out for those that are lost to bring them home to you, Father.
Yes.
So, Father, right now, Lord, we open up this service, God. We
thank you, Lord.
Pray for the speaker. We pray for my wife, Pastor Shannon, God, that, Lord, the words that you gave her, God, will be edifying unto you, God. That, Lord, they'll be uplifting, God, and encouraging, Lord. They'll be full of godly knowledge,
thank
God.
You,
and, Lord, that we can learn something from this, God. Prepare the hearts that are being able to join us right now, Lord, and those that are going to be chiming in later on, God, that,
yes,
Lord,
you,
that Lord, prepare their hearts to receive the Word of God, Lord.
Thank you.
And, Lord, those that don't know you, hopefully this message will bring them to come to know you, Father. So be with them and bless them. In
thank
Jesus'
you,
mighty and precious name we pray.
Thank you.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you so much for that, Pastor Vic. And I thank you for all of those that are joining us this morning. I hope this message touches your heart in some way. You could be going through a trial, a test, pain, sickness, suffering. And I just really hope that this message that the Lord laid on my heart, that it would touch you in some way. So for those of you that like to take notes, two of the scriptures that I will be reading is 1 Samuel chapter 16, verse 13. The other scripture is 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 50. And there will be a couple other scriptures, and we'll get to those later. But the title of my message this morning is Important Lessons from the Life of David. And so we all know the story, or hopefully we all know the story of David. And you and I are no different than David. And so this morning, I just want to briefly go over it with you and what I actually mean by this. First of all, I'd like to give you some background on David and David's life. He was the youngest of 8 children, and his father was Jesse. His father was from Bethlehem. And at that time in biblical history, the Lord was looking for a new king. And he asked Samuel, he said, "Samuel, I want you to go to Jesse. I want you to go to him in Bethlehem and tell him which one of his sons to anoint." The result was that the Lord told Samuel to anoint David,
Amen.
Who happened to be the youngest. And I'm sure there's plenty of you watching that are the youngest of 8 children, maybe 10 children. I know that my husband definitely was the youngest of 8 children, and his dad of 18 children was the oldest. And I can't imagine having 18 children. No, thank you. So let's go on. So he happened to be the youngest son. Now in 1 Samuel chapter 16, it reads this. "So Samuel took the horn of oil and he anointed him in the presence of his brothers. And from that day on, the Spirit of the Lord came upon David in power." Now this is a familiar example of the extent of God's power and what God's power can do and the anointing in David's life. Amen?
Amen.
And this is demonstrated in 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 50. And I will be reading, "So David triumphed over the Philistine, which is Goliath." And we all know the story about Goliath. "With a sling and a stone, without a sword in his hand. He struck down the Philistine and he killed him." Now, how many of us would be able to go against a giant the size of Goliath? So in the spiritual sense, it's the Lord that is with you. And if the Lord tells you that you can take that giant out, then know and trust in God.
Amen.
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 So we see here, and we've learned some of the important life lessons and the lessons of David's walk with God. Just like yours, just like all of ours, our life lessons with God. Now David knew that the battle was in the Lord's hands, and his faith brought about his great victory over Goliath. Now I want to stop right there. I want to ask you this morning, for those of you that may be watching right now, or maybe those that might be tuning in later, how many of you really trust in God and know that he has given you the power to get through that battle? Amen?
Amen.
So we see here that David had favor as well as victory with God. And that's illustrated in 2 Samuel chapter 7, verse 15. And I'll read that. "But my love will never be taken away from you, as I took it away from Saul, whom I removed from before you." So we see there, as it is illustrated, that God had given him not only the faith, but the power to overcome that battle. So I don't know what kind of a battle that you might be going through, but as we can see here in life lessons from David, we all go through life lessons. Amen?
Amen.
So we're no different than him. So now as David learned some powerful life lessons throughout his life, I would hope that we all learn from life lessons. No matter how old, no matter how young, I would hope that you've learned from life lessons.
Yes, amen.
That God has taken us through. Now, just like David, he had a choice to learn from these life lessons. Just like us, we have that choice. Now, our relationship with God is centered on our freedom to make choices. They can be good choices or bad choices. And let's face it, I know for me, I've made some bad choices in my life. And I've made some good choices, just like David. David did make some bad choices during his lifetime. And we can vividly see that throughout 1 and 2 Samuel. And one of them was the adulterous affair that he had with Bathsheba, which resulted in her husband's murder. So maybe not to that extent that you've made that type of a bad choice, but I can bet on it that you've made some bad choices in your life.
Yes.
As I said, I have as well. And we need to learn from those choices. So when we choose to make bad choices in our life, I am sure all of you that are hearing this now can relate to this. Maybe not exactly as it happened in David's life, but I am sure that there are choices that you've made, and we can relate, and we know that there are consequences to making bad choices. Amen?
Amen.
Now, we can't cover up sin, because that just leads to more sin. And we can't hide from God, because God sees everything. Amen? So, now David's life, he was thinking that he had gotten away with this sin. And we know that none of us can get away. I'm talking about believers out there. Believers, you and I. We can't get away with it. Just like David. David could not get away with it. Now we know that David was a king and he was under construction. Just like you, just like me, we're under construction. God is molding us. He is shaping us. We're an onion. He's peeling the layers and letting us know that by the time he has pulled away everything that he needs to pull away, we're going to be that fine gem.
Yes,
amen?
Amen. Amen.
Now, we know that David was a godly man, despite what he had done. He was a godly man. And he was a man with passion. He was a man just like us. Now, we can benefit greatly from David. He went through triumphs. He went through tests. He went through trials. And he went through life lessons, just like us. Now, I know for me, there's been some life lessons, some that I've learned from and some that I repeated. But I know that God has a plan for my life.
Yes, amen.
And I know the lessons that I have gone through are lessons to teach me. And I know that I have a passion for my Heavenly Father. So I know the message that the Lord had given me this morning wasn't just for you, but it was also for me.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen. Amen.
Now, when we're facing trials, and we're facing challenges, and we're facing testing, and we're maybe going through some suffering, and we have pain, or maybe it's sickness in your body, I believe, and I'm just saying for me, I'm not saying for every one of you, but this is just what I believe. I believe that the Lord takes us through those things. I believe that whether it is a challenge, whether it is a trial, whether it is you're being tested, whether it is you're sick and you're saying, how come I'm not healed? I believe that it's for a purpose.
Yes, that's right.
And it's His plan and His will. And who are we to question God? Amen?
Amen.
So often, we forget what we ought to remember. And we remember what we ought to forget.
Come on.
So let me say that again.
Good. Say it again.
So often we forget what we ought to remember, and we remember what we ought to forget. So I want you to sit and just take a quick moment and ponder on that. We remember things that we should actually forget, and then we forget things that we should actually remember. So I know for me, I am guilty of that. And I know that I need to remind myself of the battles, the life lessons that God has taken me through. And I hope He's done the same for you. So now we remember our defeats and we forget our victories. We have a tendency to weigh in on and entertain things that maybe have happened in our life because of choices we made or because we thought we heard from God and we did things that we shouldn't have done because we thought we were hearing right or we thought that was the right choice. And we forget about all the victories when the Lord healed us, when He brought us up that mountain, when He got us through that test. We forget those. So I'm here this morning to tell you, I think it's a great idea that if you are taking notes, and if you're one of those that loves to journal, write down your prayers that have been answered. Write down the victories that the Lord has brought you through. Amen?
Amen.
Now, most of us can recite failures. And I know that I'm speaking to someone here this morning. Most of us can recite failures in our lives. And we even bring vivid detail to them. We recite failures of what happened as a child. We recite failures as a teenager, as a grown adult, maybe in our marriage. Maybe something that happened with your mom and dad, a brother, a sister, whatever it may be, we recite those failures. And then we have vivid detail. But we're not specific about those remarkable victories that God gave us. All those victories that He gave to us in our past. Or maybe even recently, we're not thinking specifically about those victories. So I want you this morning, if you haven't done it lately, I just want you to thank our Heavenly Father for the trials and for the victories.
Yes, amen.
I'll say that again. Thank our Heavenly Father for the trials and for the victories. Amen?
Amen.
So I'm starting to wrap up, and I just want to say, we can benefit greatly from this important lesson in David's life. And I want to give two of them, so if you're taking notes, this would be the time to write these down. These are two ways that I was shown how we can learn from these lessons in David's life. One, be committed to whatever the cause, whatever it is you're doing. Stop being flaky. Stop being wishy-washy. Be committed. David was known as a man after God's own heart. And that's in 1 Samuel 13, verse 14. Be committed. Go after what it is that God's telling you. Do what God's told you to do. Stay committed. No matter what trial, no matter what test, no matter what challenge, no matter what sickness, no matter what pain that you may be facing, just know that He wants you to stay committed. Amen?
Amen.
And the second life lesson, be courageous. There is so much going out in this world today. You know, there's people that I talk to that say, I don't even leave my house anymore. I'm afraid to go to the grocery store. I'm afraid to go out to eat. Well, if you're a believer, shame on you, because you should be courageous. I want you to write down 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 32, and 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 45. David wasn't afraid to face the giant Goliath. You want to know why? Because he was focused on what he had. Right? Goliath was focused on what he had. He had size. He had strength. He had armor. And he had weapons. But guess what? David's focus was on what he had. And can you tell me what that was? He had the Lord. He had the Lord to go before him and fight that battle. Amen?
Amen.
So he knew that he could be courageous. I don't care if it's 5 people coming against you. I don't care if it's 10 people coming against you. The Lord's word says, fear no man.
That's right.
So be courageous. And this morning, in closing, by David's strength, by David's weaknesses, these are just great examples. And we need to learn from them. Amen?
Amen.
And we need to seek him more. And we need to tell others about life lessons, our own life lessons, as well as sharing David's life lessons. So I just want to thank you this morning. I want to thank you for joining this morning. I want to thank you for tuning in. I pray that this ministered to you. I pray that it touched your heart. I would like you to check out our website, fightthegoodfightministries.com. Check us out on Facebook, Fight the Good Fight Ministries as well. Send me an email. If you need prayer, email me. If you have my number, call me. But I would like you to join us. And I want to let you know what's upcoming on Monday, August 3rd at 10 o'clock a.m. in the morning. Our new show, it's called The Morning Show with Pastor Vic and Shannon.
Yay.
It's going to be exciting. We're going to talk about politics. Yes, politics. We're going to talk about our faith. We're going to talk about marriage. We're going to talk about what's going on out there. We're going to have speakers. So please join us. We thank you so much. Thank you. God bless.